if you still think Obama is a Muslim, you just might be a redneck. A Christian church in South Carolina has a sign out front that says, Obama, Osama, are they brothers? No. In fact, they're not even related, which is more than I can say for the married couples in your church.
That's Bill Maher at his best on HBO's Real Time with Bill Maher. The show returns Friday, February 20th at a new time, live at 10 o'clock Eastern. You can also see it at 10 o'clock on the West Coast. You can also see it at 7 o'clock on the West Coast. You could also see it at 11 o'clock on the East Coast.
Well, 7 if you have the, HBO channel, I think.
That's right. Well, yeah, that's right. You have the whole DirecTV.
You have the whole package.
From our blog at CNN.com, Larry King, Michael writes, as a supporter of the arts, how do you feel about the recent cuts in funding to education in the stimulus package affecting music and art programs in public schools?
Sir, you're assuming things about me you don't know. I am not a supporter of government funding of the arts. I have always been for abolishing the National Endowment for the Arts. Government has absolutely no business or need to be in funding of the arts. I consider what I do an art of types, you know, stand-up comedy. I never needed the government.
How about young artists, pianists?
You know, how about pianists? You play the piano.
You don't want them to, you don't like them in the public schools training them, teaching
well,
them?
Well, I think...
You like music courses?
You know, I guess it could be part of the curriculum. Yeah, I mean, I took music in school, but, you know, that's school. But if you're talking about the National Endowment for the Arts, no, I don't agree with that. I don't think the government... Because it's way out of the purview of government. It's mission creep. You know, it's the very definition of that in government. There's no reason for it. I don't know why government has to do that. First of all, you cannot stop artists. If people want to create, they're going to create. And let the marketplace decide what people want to patronize of that creation. Why should government do it? Why should we spend our money on it?
Tampa, Florida, hello.
Yes, Larry. My question for Bill Maher is, what are your thoughts on companies such as Merrill Lynch giving out billions of dollars in bonuses despite major losses and then getting billions of dollars in taxpayer bailout money? It seems like we're rewarding bad behavior.
Huh, to say the least. Well, I think it's disgusting. I mean, it makes me so angry, like I think every other American. I mean, and, you know, for people who are wondering which approach is correct now, Obama's or what the Republicans in Congress are proposing, it wasn't that long ago. It was only a few months ago that the Republicans were running the show. And this is what happened. You know, just a few months ago, it was Bush and Paulson at the wheel. And what did they do? They gave all this money to the banks, no regulation, no strings, and these guys just basically stole it. Citibank lost $10 billion in a quarter, and they took that as a green light to go buy a private jet. I mean...
You say cancel it.
Yeah, they let the foxes guard the hen house, and then the foxes ate the hens, and then we gave them money to go eat at KFC. Go eat some more hens and chicken.
Citicorp has named the new... stadium in New York,
right?
The Mets were housed. It looks like an old Ebbets Field, a beautiful place. But they give the Mets $20 million a year,
right?
For many, many, many years.
Well, I mean, that's another thing. Why are we subsidizing sports teams as we do to build stadiums? Cities always do that. It's a private enterprise. If you want to build a ballpark and put a ball team in there and have people pay to see them, they'll do it. Why should the government be involved in that? You know, we've had this idea for so long in this country that the Republican idea of trust in the goodness of rich people. Just give them all the money. They always do the right thing with it. I mean, how the Republicans at this point can have the nerve to sit up there and talk about how we should run this country financially? Who drove the car into the ditch? Talking about fiscal conservatism? I mean, they're the ones who in the last 8 years gave Bush the Medicare entitlement program. That's $1 trillion money that was urgently not needed. The Iraq war, there's $1 trillion. That's why we don't have any money. You know, Bush blew a giant hole in the budget. Who was the last guy to do that before him? It was Reagan. Who is this fantasy fiscally conservative Republican who left the country more fiscally sound than he found it? I think it was Bill Clinton.
Michelle Obama. Now, what does Bill think of our First Lady? That's ahead. Stay with us. We're back with Bill Maher. Don't forget, Religious goes on sale in DVD next week. What are you putting up your hands? You're proud of this?
I am. They finally can't stop you from seeing it.
You can get it now, even in South Dakota. What do you think of Michelle Obama?
Love her. She's great. I mean, you know, it's so interesting to watch, not just her, but him too. It's so different than what we're used to. They're real. You know, they have this confidence that they don't need a teleprompter. They don't need to have a clack of hired people to talk to. You know, for years, Bush only talked to the people who weren't onto him, who at some point became only military bases and toddlers. And the toddlers were catching on, Larry. You know, the idea that Obama the other day went out and talked in that town hall setting to a crowd of whoever, you know? Yeah. They weren't hand-picked.
The boy-girl questions, yeah.
Yeah, they weren't picked by party or, you know, loyalty. And she's the same way, you know, she's off the cuff, she's real. When you see them together, you know, they have eye contact as opposed to frozen smiles. You know, when you see them, you don't get the feeling that it's anything different than who they really are, whereas the last many presidents, you get the feeling, okay, this is the facade, this is what they're putting out in public. I don't know what goes on behind closed doors, but with George and Laura or Bill and Hillary, but, you know, whatever we're seeing in public, it's not what goes on. These two, I feel like, oh, there are some real people there.
And is Sarah Palin going to be a force?
I hope so.
Want her to be a force?
Of course.
Because you're a comic.
Yes, because I'm a comic, and because I think she's a real gut check for that Republican Party. I mean, a lot of them still like her. Okay, if that's the road you want to go down, please go down that road. That's more of the know-nothing road, the people who, you know, you want to have a beer with. And I think this is what we need to find out about.
She's been critical of some conservatives lately.
Really?
Gone against the grain a little lately, and critical of the way she was handled by the McCain campaign.
Why doesn't she just go away for a while? She's like a reality show contestant who just lost, and they're always like, you know, you haven't heard the end of me. I'm not going to... Yes, you are, Sanjaya. Goodbye, bye-bye. You know, just lay low for a while, Sarah.
But she was good for you guys.
She was good, and she will be good. Because, you know, I could do an entire program called Another Thing Sarah Palin Doesn't Know. Because the list just went on and on. You know, she couldn't name a Supreme Court case. She thought Africa was one country. I mean, she made Bush look like a professor, this girl.
What do you make of our friend Joe Biden?
Well, as I mentioned a few minutes ago, he needs to, you know, not always speak his mind.
Well, but that's good. You want someone who speaks his
mind. No, come on. This is politics. It's a rough town. They're going to seize on anything. This is twice now he's done this. He hasn't been vice president that long, that 30% comment. Even if we do everything right, we'll probably get 30% of it wrong. What sort of a thing is that to say to inspire confidence?
But Joe's been doing that all his career.
Yes, he has. But he has. But now he's really on the big stage. And I love Joe. I mean, Joe was a frequent guest on our show, and I'm sure now he won't be. Because, you know, that's what happens to our show. Once they get their ass up in the tree, they forget about us. Because we might ask the tough questions.
Oh, Bill, you speak.
It's true. It's true. They will, you know, Rahm Emanuel used to do our show all the time. I doubt if we'll see him again.
What do you like more, performing or hosting Real Time?
That's a hard one. That's like asking what child of mine, not that I have children, as you well know.
No.
I like better, but I mean, I do love stand-up comedy. You know, I mean, it's where I started. It's the golden goose. It's from which everything else flows, and it's very pure. You know, it's just me and the audience. And I can get stoned for it. No, I'm kidding.
I'm guessing Bill has a few choice words about Rod Blagojevich. We'll see in 60 seconds.